Hello guys and gals, Buffalo here. I'm out here today doing a follow-up video on the rimfire LCRx 3-inch barreled revolvers. Got one in 22 LR and one in 22 Magnum. The last time I had them out, I done an ammunition test between the CCI mini mags in 22 LR and the MAXI-MAG in 22 Magnum, 22 WMR Winchester Magnum rimfire. And posted those results and got a ton of comments in that video saying that that video was not complete if I didn't shoot ballistics gel. So today that's what we're going to do. I've got a block of ballistics gel set up back behind me and we're going to shoot that here in just a minute. To catch those people up that might be watching this video first instead of the other one first, I was averaging 1,090 feet per second and 95 foot-pounds of energy out of the 22 LR mini mag. And I was averaging 1,257 feet per second and 140 foot-pounds of energy from the CCI MAXI-MAG 22 Magnum. So, like I said, got a ton of comments wanting me to shoot ballistics gel. I've got one back here. Let's take a look at it and shoot it. This video should be pretty simple. Here's a look at my gel block. According to FBI standards, the calibration of ballistics gelatin is verified by firing a 177 caliber steel BB at 590 feet per second into the gelatin. A total penetration should be between 2.95 and 3.74 inches. This batch had a penetration with the BB of 3.25 inches. Look how clear that is. Just like grandma used to make, except without the lumps. Okay, so up first, I've got the 22LR mini mag 36 grain hollow point. And up next, the 22 Magnum 40 grain jacketed hollow point. All right, let's have a look. All right, so I thought that 16 inches of ballistics gel would be enough to catch both those bullets out of those short barrels, but I was wrong. Take a look at that 22 Magnum wound channel and track here, and it goes right on out the back of the block. So we're getting more than 16 inches of ballistics gel penetration with the 22 Magnum out of the 3-inch barrel. And check out that wound channel, how wide it is right here, compared to the 22 LR, which barely left any kind of expansion channel at all. Sitting right here, let's measure it. Sorry if this video gets shaky, I'm holding the video camera by hand. So we're sitting right at 10 inches with the 22 LR mini mag, and there is no expansion on that bullet. It's actually sitting there backwards with the rear of the bullet facing forward. So, there's the results of the ballistic gel. I know that's not going to satisfy everybody since I didn't catch the 22 Magnum bullet. People are going to want to know if it expanded or not, and I can't answer that today. I'll cut that bullet out of there and get back on the main camera here. Guys, I apologize if this video has a hurried feel to it. Just as I was cutting that gel block open, the rain started. And it looks like it's going to rain all day after that. downside to living in Kentucky. I always get comments saying, man, I wish I could trade you that rain. We're so dry here or whatever. Man, I wish I could trade you too. I really do. I've gotten used to it at this point. I'm just explaining to you guys why the video may seem hurried. It's raining on me right now. I did pull that bullet out, and it did have a little bit of expansion. The cavity opened up just a little bit. Here's one unfired. You can see that bullet cavity versus the one that was in the gel. Now, I wish I could have caught the .22 Magnum and saw what it looked like. Wasn't able to do that today. A lot of you guys will say, well, this video's inconclusive, but it makes the point. You know, remember the original argument in the first video. A lot of people were telling me that when it comes to a short-barreled revolver, power-wise, you might as well shoot the .22 LR over the .22 Magnum because the .22 Magnum loses so much velocity that it's weaker than the .22 LR. We've definitely disproved that. So the video's not totally inconclusive, even though I didn't catch the .22 Magnum. We know that it went through more than 16 inches of gel, and really that's all we need to know, since the .22 LR stopped at 10 inches. But I've got to get this camera in out of the rain. It is not weatherproof. And I guess that's all I got. So I'll talk with you guys again soon. All right, scratch that. As I was loading everything up on the golf cart and getting ready to head back up, the rain has stopped for a few minutes. So I set the ballistics gelatin block back up, and I put two jugs of water behind the block. I really want to catch one of these .22 Magnum bullets and see if they're expanding. So I'm going to hurry up and do this while I've got a few minutes here. Got lucky and got a break. So let's give this a shot. Let's go have a look. All right, so that worked out good. Now we've got a third track in the ballistics gel. Don't know how well you guys can see that. I'm gonna go around to the other side. It's the lowest one. Like, I've got these two up top. That last shot was this low one. Didn't intersect with any of the other channels. Goes out the gel, and I see a bullet in that first jug. So this worked out good. When I take the lid off this jug, it's going to start bleeding out. And there is our bullet. So as you can see, no expansion through the bare ballistics gel. Now, that doesn't mean that the first shot didn't expand, as that shot did leave a larger expansion channel in the ballistics gel, but it does tell us that we won't get reliable expansion. So I did underestimate the penetration of the .22 Magnum just by a little bit. If I'd have had a few more inches of ballistics gel, I think we would have caught it. But you know what? The old hillbilly ways that I use ended this video successfully anyway. So there you guys have it. Now I can say that's all I've got, and I'll talk with you guys again soon. Y'all stay safe out there.